just to think that 100 years ago, these technologies were starting to be built. It keeps the cities livable because this is a point source of lots of flow coming in, lots of flow going out. It's all done in one small step, highly efficient.
We're at the Stickney Water Reclamation Plant. We serviced pretty much Chicago and about 46 communities. So what wastewater is essentially is any of the water that you use in your home, industry, or wherever that goes down the drain, we essentially treat it here. We treat it to a standard where basically it's good and safe for the fish and aquatic species of the waterway that we discharge to. We have a screening process, a core screening process that has these bars on it, about 1 or 2 inch bars, to prevent any kind of large debris or material from going through.
So this is what comes into us. I'm gonna shake it up a little. You can see it's cloudy, it's murky, it's really grayish. We're using naturally occurring bacteria to actually do the work to purify the sewage that's coming in. We're actually using oxygen, air that we compress, in order to give the bacteria the oxygen that it needs to survive.
From aerated grit, it moves on to what we call preliminary or primary tanks. We get more of the organic material settling out.
Over time, that blanket settles. You get the sludge at the bottom of the tank. We remove that sludge for solids treatment processes to produce biosolids. This is our final effluent. This is what it looks like when it's leaving the plant. You can see all of the debris, all of the clumps have been removed from it. It's very clear it's not drinkable. We do not produce drinking water here, but this is what it looks like when it's gone through the entire process.
After we have that aeration system, then the water is essentially good enough to discharge to the sanitary ship canal.
This channel is what feeds the sanitary and ship canal. And under the right conditions, you can see that there's actually goldfish living down there in the tank. The technology is not new. It's been going on for a long time. The earliest part of our facility opened in 1930, and where we're standing now, this side of the plant started operation in 1939. It's a tried and true method of treatment.